Buttons. All right, how's it going, guys? Ed here, Showtime SPL. Today I want to talk about something I have talked about before, and that is buttons, switches, buttons and switches. Well, there's a lot of different types. There's some confusion surrounding styles, types, things like that. But we're going to get into the differences in how to specify them or how to choose them when you're shopping. Let's look at the switches that I actually have here. You see, we have several different types. They look a little bit different, and we have mostly metal, but to switch things up, we have plastic as well. Let's start with this guy. This might be the most well-known. The way it looks, it's a toggle switch. Well, toggle can refer to the type of action that it takes to operate it. It toggles, it has a toggle lever. But also you'll see two connection points. It's really an input and an output, we'll explain that. But it toggles between on and off. Just one operation, one action, very simple. Similar operation is a rocker switch that is also on off. Now this one has the added feature of a built-in LED. And that LED has its own negative. But the other two poles, or posts, I should say, are just input output, just like the toggle there. So essentially this is a rocker, sometimes also called a toggle switch, but mostly what we're gonna refer to when we label the switches or the style of switch is the type of interaction that it takes. So this is a rocker, this is a toggle. Now a different type of rocker switch would be a two-way momentary. Now this could be used for, say, power windows or something of that nature. Something where it requires you constantly pressing on it to perform that action. And it rocks back and forth between the two actions so that they don't interfere with each other. So up down of a power window motor would be a perfect example of that. And you'll see that it has three connection points, which would be a common input with two outputs because it has two functions. So still a very basic switch. Then we have some push buttons here. We have different varieties. This one is just a large type. You'll see many different connections on this one, and we'll get into what those are. So it's more than just one input and one output, but it does serve a similar function where it has an off and an on feature. Different type of push button is a momentary push button. It only operates the accessory while we're pushing on it, and you'll see multiple connection points. This also has an LED built in, so it lights up and we can change the function of that light. Then there are, I guess you can call them rotary switches or dial switches that connect their points. You'll see all the different connection points when you turn it a certain direction. So these can be used for some other things, just a different type of operation. So that points out the idea that switches, even though their base function is all similar, the way we interact with them gives us a variety, probably hundreds of different types of switches out there. But then their function or the way that their internals work, there's only a couple different types of that. Let's show you the basic operation of each switch, starting with this guy, the toggle. And what I have is a multimeter here that is set to continuity. And what that means is when I touch the probes together, when it has a completed connection that has continuity, it's conducting electricity, it'll beep and show me on the screen. So there we go. We know that that is a good connection. And basically what a switch does, all it's doing is taking wires that's going to something, let's say a light bulb, for instance. A light bulb needs two wires, a positive and a negative. And all the switch does is break or make that connection. So the off position would have that connection open. It's like taking a wire and cutting it, that it won't be connected. And when you push that button, it connects them. It's like twisting those wires together. So we can see that this one's marked on and off. So we should have no connection in off. can see the probes do work. No connection, but as soon as we flip it, we have a connection. So that'll turn our items on and off. Then we can go to a push button switch. You can see these switches here. It's just a nice metal push button switch. And yes, these do illuminate. However, I'm not gonna get into that right now. So the wires coming off of this pigtail do have a positive and negative for the onboard LED. So it looks a little confusing, but there's extra wires there just for the light. But we are going to demonstrate the poles. This one will be considered, the toggle switch is considered normally open. The normal operation is this default off position, unactivated position. So this is NO, we'd see this as an NO. And then the closed position is what takes action. These push button switches, one of the other wires is because it has two poles. This is a two throws, I should say. This is a single pole, dual throw, which means it throws from one position to the other. So it has a normally closed and a normally open. So it's basically taking one wire connection, cutting it and moving it over to another wire connection, and I'll demonstrate that here. Now we use our common, actually on this one, I believe it's green. And the red and the black, by the way, they are for the LED, we are not touching them. No connection from green to white. That means that is normally open. But from green to blue, we have a connection. That is normally closed. So in the off position, that's closed. So we can use this in a circuit that we want to turn off one thing and activate another when we push the button. And see, we pushed the button and we broke that connection, but we made the connection between the green and the white. And if we want to break that connection, we just turn it off. So this is an on-off push button, and it's latching. You see that operation? That is a latching operation. So far the toggle switch and the push button are both latching types. So they will allow us to activate something that needs constant current flowing to it without our operation. They actually latch. Now, this same kind of push button switch is available in momentary, and that's what this guy does. So let's connect this one to the same harness. Now, if we remember, we had green as our common, which is our input, goes to our battery, let's say. And then we had blue and white as our normally closed and open. So blue, right now in the normal operation, is connected, is on. Let's push the momentary button. See, it breaks that connection while I'm pushing. If I let go, it reconnects. Now, let's go off to the white. So again, this is a single pole dual throw. It's throwing between one connection to the other. However, unlike the other latching push button, this one only operates as I'm pushing it. So again, this will be used, say, for a horn or power windows or a motor or something of that nature that only can operate while we're pushing it, just like that. So far we've talked about the two different operation types or interface types, which would be a toggle and a push button. And we've talked about two different operation types of latching, means on, off, on, off, and momentary, on, off, on, off. We've also talked about two single pole switches. One has a single throw, one, and the other has a dual throw. We also have dual pole single throw and dual pole double throw. Now here we have an interesting switch. It is a latching push button switch, and it can be used for on-off operation. However, the poles are a little bit different in that it has kind of a dual pull, dual throw feature going on here, where in the off position, there is a normally closed pole and a normally open pole. Now, watch when we push it with the blues. So this is what you would use to turn on something, and the two yellows would be used to turn off something. So you would use this, use the yellows to turn off something when you hit the switch, and use the two blues to turn on something when you push the switch. So the poles are a little bit different than the other one. However, it still is a latching push button switch, pretty basic. Now, another type of switch we have also performs an on-off. However, there's two different throws to this switch. And it's not a push button. It is latching. You can see it latches. And then off. So let's take a look at how this one operates. This one has poles. You'll see, actually, that there's six connection points. And that's because it has two poles and it throws two different ways. So the two poles can actually connect to one side or the other, make six connection points. So it's a dual pole, dual throw, DPDT. And let's demonstrate that here with, it's actually marked. Common is the input. Normally open is the normal non-connection when it's in the off mode. And normally closed is when it's normally connected in the off position. So we'll use green as our common. And you'll see this switch actually operates in two different directions. And the middle is off. So each of those directions does something different on those poles. So green is common. Let's go to the blue. So we have a connection. Let's see if we can hold this. And there, we turned it off and then back on. So that would be the normally closed, and the green to the white, I should say. Normally open, no connection. Turn it, turns on. Turn that in one direction, it turns on. Turn it in the other direction, and you'll have the other pole operate. So this is kind of an opposite. Each pole is opposite of each other, but it's a dual pole, dual throw turning switch. I call it the turny switch. Now let's do switch things up and take a little reprieve to play with the rocker switch that illuminates. This has an LED in it, and one of our push button power switches. This has a symbol in it that illuminates, and we're going to show that off using a 9-volt battery, of course. Now, the way that our push button switches are, you can see that nuts just to tighten it, like I said, you can wire up the LED separate so that it could illuminate from something, some other function, or when you do operate the switch, when you turn it on. The rocker switch has a separate ground for its LED, but the positive is built in to the actual terminal post. But they're both useful to help you know, they indicate when an operation is being made, and they illuminate and look pretty cool, I must say. Let's look at the operation of these rocker switches. So to catch you up, we do have the toggle switches. We do have the push button switches. We have the rotary or turny switches. And we do have the rocker switches. There are other types out there, like capacitive touch, pressure switches, there's mercury switches, there's temperature switches. There's a lot of different types of switches out there, reed switches that interface differently or activate differently. However, these are the types that I have here to show you. We're not getting into relays or anything digital that takes capacitive touch or anything like that. However, just know that all the different ways you can interface or act with a switch will determine like the style of switch it is. And their basic function is still going to be the same. They're still going to have things like single pole, single throw, single pole, dual throw, dual pole, single throw, dual pole, single throw. There's even three pole, four pole, a lot of different types out there. Latching, momentary, timed, things like that. But let's not get away from ourselves too much because I want to show you these basic rocker switches. There's also something called paddle switches that is more like a toggle. It looks like it has a paddle on it. That's all. It doesn't help you get around a lake or anything in a canoe. All right. Anyway, here is a basic rocker. And let's check the operation with this. If I can get the meter probes on there. There we go. All right, see that? So we have on, off. On, off. So what that switch is doing when we hit the rocker is there's an internal connection between these two terminals that is opening and closing. As we move it. It's the same thing if we were going to take two wires, hold them together, and then disconnect them. Hold them together and disconnect them. That's too tough to do when you have all these switches in the world that operate all the different things. You have all these different types of switches to even just turn on a light. Different types of switches to operate machinery, turn on TV screens, to turn on computers, to operate things in your car, on your dashboard, all the different functions that your vehicles can do. All these different types of switches, and all they really are doing is connecting wires and disconnecting wires. So it's too hard to do that manually. We're not going to sit there and hold all these connections by hand. We employ switches to do that for us. Okay, so that was the rocker, which is a latching rocker. It turns on and off. You can flip it, walk away, and it's still operating the thing you want to operate. However, we do have momentary rockers with dual throws, and that can allow us to control things while holding it that have two different functions that shouldn't be functioning at the same time, like a power window going up and down. And so this is a momentary rocker. And you can see it even has markers on it for which direction you want it to go, or the operation, operation one, operation two. So this will have a single pole. So it has one common, which is an input. So the wire you want to connect to make that connection, it comes in and then two out to go to the different motors or directions for the motor or relays or whatever it is, right? So, or you can use this for two different horns in a car if you wanted to do that. But it's a rocker switch because of the way it moves. It's momentary because it's only on for a moment while you're holding it. And it's a single pole dual throw because it has a single pole that throws two different ways. That's what it's doing. And let's demonstrate that. So we could see right now, since it's momentary, without action, there should be no connection, no continuity. Now this is going to be hard for me to hold. There we go. I'll hold those two there and push it with my thumb, if I can. There we go. So now we make a connection as we push. So the other direction should be these two poles. And it is. So isn't that fantastic? We have a momentary rocker and the connection works. Now here's something cool that I want to show you. If you guys remember, some of your old heads out there, the Nintendo, we do have the latching switch used for power on off. on, off. And a momentary switch, reset. How cool is that? Now that gives us a frame of reference of what we're talking about, doesn't it? All right, I want to thank you guys for joining me today. This has been fun. I do want to do more kind of tip type videos and explanations on things. So leave a comment below. What did you think? Do you have any questions about switches, about their operation, what they do, things we talked about today? Let me know, and hopefully you stick around for more. Give me a thumbs up and share this video if you found it useful. If you think it'll help someone else out there, sure, send it to them to get a better understanding on switches. Thank you guys again. Hope you have a nice day, and may the bass be with you.